population of 130 million people, only 800,000. That is not even 1 million pay tax. And out of those 800,000, 500,000 are government servants. So that tax is deducted at source. And that comes to only 300,000. And I kept telling my machinery that just take the big cities, Islamabad, Lahore, Karachi, you know, the big cities. And I said, go out there and see if there's a man who has a Land Cruiser. A Land Cruiser costs $200,000 in Pakistan. If he has a Land Cruiser, he should be paying tax. I said, go out and see who has a house that is built on more than 1,000 square yards. I don't know what square yards use here, or 1,000 square yards. I said, if you can afford to have a house on 1,000 square yards, you can afford to be paying tax. But the machinery would not act. And then I said, let's privatize taxation. And when I said, let's privatize taxation, because somebody came up to me with a proposal and said that you give me a market. There was a market in a city called Lahore, and they said, you give me market, and I will sign an agreement with you that I will give you 30 times more revenue than you are presently collecting. So I said, that sounds good. And as soon as I said it, they said, it's corruption. Why aren't you having a tender? Now, in a tender, anybody can come forward. I have no guarantee that they're really going to give me 30 times more or not. Somebody who's come up with the idea, who's been innovative enough, taken the initiative, should be rewarded for their innovation or their initiative. So in Pakistan, it's a lot of gridlock, you know. Even if you have ideas, how do you break through? And I think the first thing that we needed, which I wanted to do, I said, in my third year in office, you know, because the first year I thought the bureaucracy is going to do it for me. So in my third year of office, I said, why don't I get university students? Or why don't I get the police? Or why don't I get a team of people together to go house to house and come back and say who's a taxpayer and who's not a taxpayer? And then I introduced something called the national tax number. And I said, everybody must pay the national tax, have a national tax number. And I said, anybody who does not have a national tax number and goes to buy a car, which costs $100,000, will have to pay a 15% as a fine, because that means they have enough money to be paying tax. And I said, anybody who wants to fly to America, which costs about $5,000 round trip, which is a lot of money for Pakistan because we have purchase power parity and all that, I said, they should be paying tax. Well, as soon as I went, they changed it, because I had said that if I was buying and I showed my card, I was exempt. So they said that you could buy as long as I showed my card, you'd be exempt. So obviously you're not collecting taxes. So I think what we need to do is have a legislation which is broad-minded, with the opposition and the government equally represented. And I think what we need to do is crack down on people who are living so overtly, ostentatiously. I mean, it's really sickening that one has so much poverty on one side, and then we have so much affluence on the other side, and we have only 800,000 taxpayers. I mean, have affluence. I'm one of those people, I say, if you work hard, it's your money. Do what you want with it. But pay your dues. And if you pay your dues, I have no problem.